Okay, so let's get started. So yesterday, where were we actually? Data sets, right? Okay, there are two things. Okay, one is you set operators, and then okay, so we have so far done with all except to, I think, set and then data set. Okay, so first I'll show very quickly set. Set is nothing but set operators. Generally, in your 10th standards and plus two, oh, sorry, in elementary schools, you might have learned operators. Okay, union and intersect, minus, and all that. Okay, so in the same way. So here also, so now I have two operators here, okay? Okay, so now here I have two tables. One contains, okay, should be white. Okay, we have two tables here. Okay, so one table is 10 and another table is 20. This contains only this and this. So if I want, so if I give you these two tables and I want to read data from both tables, but in the first table we have employees who are working in 10, second table we have employees who are working in 20. So I want to read all of them and load into single target, or I want to combine them. Okay, so see, many the new people are get confused. Okay, when we ask a question, so I have some data in two tables, some employees in 10, some means employees means who are working in 10 in this table, and some employees who are working in 20 in this table. So I want to read all the employees, load into one target table. So mostly what people will say join actually, but always when we you have to understand the question. Okay, have some employees in 10 and I have some employees working in 20. So 10 employees in the first table, 20 employees in the second table. I want to read all the employees, means what you have to do in Oracle, just say in Oracle, I have some employees and I want to read all the employees. I want to display all the employees data. So mostly people initially somehow knowing or unknowingly, they'll say join actually. So the question is very important to understand. In this table, we have department 10 records. In this table, we have department 20 records. If you join, what happens? Can we join both? We have a common column is there, department number. If you join, what happens? Yeah, so here we have 10, here we have 20, so it cannot join. So you can join technically, but nothing, it will go and try to match 10. So this is absolutely wrong actually. So when we say reading all the data, joining means matching. So I have some information here, I have some information other side, I want to match it. In the matching case, you have to, if you take employee and department, for every employee is working in some department, we have a department number. In which, what is the name of the department name? If you want, you can go to join department table. So matching data you are going. Here I have some records here, I have some records here. Okay, and we need to read all, or we need to combine. So you can use, in if it is a database RDBMS, you can use union. So what is union? There are two things. Okay, so focus much on the see, tool is nothing great. Tool is not there from the beginning. SQL is there from the beginning. Only tool is helping you to generate the SQL, whether it is a Informatica or ODI or anything. So that's why you have to be, so your pillars have to be strong. So you are building floors on top of the pillars. Okay, and then you go and see, you can stay in your rooms, but your pillar is not there, there's nothing. Okay, so here also, basic SQL is mandatory, then only you can think about others. If you know basic, most of the people in industry, they are lagging the technology for the only one reason is, they learn the tool, but they don't know SQL. So there is a big, okay, only in that case, if you learn, you will know only FAQs. You can answer only FAQs, and apart from that, you cannot answer anything. So basic SQL is mandatory. The tool is helping you to write SQLs graphically, that's all. It will, again, any tool will go internally, generate the SQLs and all internal code. So that's why SQL is mandatory. So now, this is also SQL. I'm trying, we have some records here, we have some records here. So I want to read both. So the first operator which I'm showing you is union all. maybe in your mathematics standards, you know set operators. Okay, you have a union, intersect, minus. What is union does? It will combine all. Okay, so here also we have two things. One, first I am talking about union all. So what union all does, it will take first query result set, it will take second query result set, and it will put together. It is not going to join. We have three and we have three, it will just put together one after one. We will see 10 and 20 records here. In the same way, there is one more operator, okay, which is called union. So union all we have seen, and so union all does the same thing, but there is a small difference. What is the difference here is, say for example, in this situation we have, so I am going to create one more table just to show you. So in this table, who are all there? 10 and 20, both are there. Now what I am doing? So in this table, how many employees we have? 9 employees. In this table, how many were there? 4. So total how many? 9 plus 4, 13. So, when I say union all, okay, 9 plus 4, 13, this is what your output, final output. So, 9 plus 1, 14, sorry, 13, okay, 9 plus 4, 13, we have the 13 employees here. But now what I am doing, I am just saying, union. So, how many we got? 9 only. So, what the union does? Union all just takes first, second, puts together, that's all. But whereas the union, it will take from both and it will combine. In case if there are any duplicate records, it will eliminate them. It will suppress them. So, right now, if you see here, in the first table we have 10 and 20. And in the second table we have 10 only. So these 4 regards already present in your first table. In the first table 10, 20 we have, second table 10. So if I combine, just put together 10, 20, 20, and if I say union all, it is going to combine. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is a 10. And if you say union all, okay, it will combine. So you see 1, 2, 3, 4, and also you will see 1, 2, 3, 4. So both are there. This is there and this is there. So it is just putting together 9 plus 4, 13. Blindly it will keep whatever is there. But when you take union, it will take all, but it is eliminating the duplicates. We have some duplicates here. If there are no duplicates, no problem. Okay. So department 10 records, that 4 records are present in the first table and also second table, so it will eliminate them. Okay, so it will not show twice, it will show only once. Wherever duplicate records are there, it will show only once. Okay, this is union, union all, and important from the database SQL interview point of view, also in ODI and in a practical. Example I'll show you. Select one from dual. Union. Select one from dual. 1 means it will just display one value. One value. This is also 1. When you say union, how many times it will show? 1. But when you say union all, it will show only, it will show 2. So it will not eliminate, union all will not eliminate. As it is, it will take and then put together. That is the reason we discussed in a full outer join. Combination of the left outer join and right outer join. If you see, left outer join will have a matched and unmatched data. Right outer join will have matched and unmatched data. So if you see, matched data is coming from two queries, left outer join and also right outer join. So when you say union, it will suppress them to 1. So that's why unmatched of the left, unmatched from the right, and then matched, you will get it, it will become a full outer join. So this is, so in the same way, we can also do some other operators like minus, intersect and all, okay. So if you, at least if you know union, union all, this is kind of an operator, okay, are called set operators, and it will help you to combine the data. And it will help you to say, if I want to see common data, or if I want to see data, something is there in the first table which is not there in the second table. So all those things will be coming into the set operator. So this is Oracle, okay. But if you want to do in ODI, okay, to support these, we have a ODI. So now I already have these two tables already added. EMP ODI 10 and 20. So now I want to join, we know. If I use join, what happens? Your data, now you will get some data. You will get some four regard because there is some common data. But always be clear, joining means matching data. Union means combining the data. You have two people and two people I am putting together. Okay. So if I have a pairs, okay, there is a husband and wife, I am pairing up, that is a different. But I am just putting together one person, so two persons. But join means matching. So because with my own experience, I am telling, 90% when I ask, okay, I'll get an answer join only. Okay, so when I understand the question, okay, this is my practical experience I'm telling. So if I say I have some employees in one place and I have some other employees in one place, I want to take and load into one table. So people will say blindly join. Okay, because there are two tables. Two tables means immediately they think about join only. But here, think about combining, joining. So you have to. Join means like this. Your final output will be 2 only. Operate, union or union on means 2 is here and 2 is here. So you'll become 4 like this. So we have a operator, set component here. So I'm taking, when you click set component, so you'll have some general properties, operators, something like this. So what I am doing, I am just taking data from here to here first, and immediately you can see in set component, input 1, input 2, and how many outputs we have, only 1 output. And by looking at this, what it indicates, you can have more than 2 input links. Okay, so means I can combine more than 2 tables into component. And then I am taking this into second one also I am taking. So you already have these columns here. And I am linking over here. So the data will come from 2 inputs. And then it will go to the 1 output. So when you are pushing data to these 2 inputs, what kind of operator you want to do? So ODI supports all. So only thing is union, union all. Wherever all word is there, without all, every operator you will see without all, with all. What is without all? What is with all? Without all means it will not eliminate duplicates. Sorry, without all will eliminate duplicates. With all, okay, will not eliminate the duplicates. Union, union all. So union will suppress the duplicates. Union all will just come. All means putting all. So here also, first I'll take by union. Okay, so now it is going to combine and say union, and this output I want to load to a target table. As usual, control append and so we got only who is this for control append is insert, that's all you are inserting data. Okay, so 9 records because union. If I use union all, did I change or not? I need to change. Okay, union all, 10 and 20, we should have data full. I think maybe I am not committed or something. Okay, so the query you can see very clearly union all. So, employee 10, T57, union all, 20. Let me verify whether I have not committed or not committed. Sorry, I am not. Okay, 9 correct only. How many we got inside? 10 we have. 4 and how many we have here? 20. 9 correct only. I'm just okay. Sorry. Actually, I was using this table in SQL. Okay, I was confused. When in SQL, I was using this table to display the output. So this is right only. So in department 10, okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and department 20 we have 5 records, And we don't have any duplicates. So since there are no duplicates, we'll get 9 only. In case if I insert, okay, let's say a few more records into this table. So right now 10 is there. Let's say let me insert some extra records into 20. So now in this case, we have 4 records in the 10 and we have 10 and 20 both in this. Okay, so if I run this, since it is a union all, it will just combine both of them and our final output should be 13. So it is not eliminating the duplicate. And if I use union, we know already. So it is just performing SQL. By looking at the SQL, you can confirm what is going to happen. As long as it is there in the SQL, that is 100%, you can confirm that it is going to we still have 9 only, because in the 10 we have 4 and there we have some 9, supposed to be 13, but still 9 only, because we have some duplicates there in this table. So this way you can use union component, set component here. Apart from this, if you see, union is there and minus is there. So what is a minus means? First table minus second table. So you have some records in the first table and you have some records in the second table. And first table minus second table. Example, I have, you can just try your queries, but I'll just show simple. So now I have 1, 2, 3 records in first table. I have 1, 2 records. So first table minus second table means, okay, you will get only 1. So this minus this. And in the same way, minus all, when you say, if at all, when it is doing this minus this, if there are any duplicates, okay, means when you present duplicates in the, I got some missing data. Within that, if you have any duplicates, it will make it 1 only. So, wherever all is there, no duplicates. Wherever there is no all, it will suppress the duplicates. So, union minus intersect. What intersect does? Intersect will give you common. So, we have some. In this case, what will be the output here? Intersect 1, 2, because they are the common ones. And in the last one, we have except all. Okay, so what is except means, okay, so except first table, except second table, it is almost equivalent to 2 only, but sometimes, okay, when you have some extra records into this table, so minus means purely this minus this, okay, combine means, intersect means common, except means, okay, so the records which are not there and which are not there, like mutually exclusive, except the records will get it. So the meaning itself, except. So again, except all, if at all in that you have any duplicates, will get it. So if you know union all, that is sufficient. Remaining all, need basis you can use and you can also execute your SQLs and you can try. Okay, now, apart from this, you will see some extra option called distinct. For every operator, you see union, union all, and union distinct. You cannot, if you see union distinct, the name itself, union means it will not eliminate duplicates. Distinct will eliminate. But we already have a function, union is already there. So if at all, if you try to use this function union distinct, just to remember, I'm running it. See that what you will get. Suppose, I think it is not saved. Okay, so this is the error I'm expecting. So set component input connector, whatever, okay, union distinct is not valid for Oracle technology. Okay, so this operator is not valid for Oracle. So there are some databases where union will not eliminate the duplicate. Okay, so in that case, for those databases you can use it, but for Oracle it is not supported. So you can ignore union distinct. Mostly you will be working on Teradata and all. So Teradata will support native, all top RDBMS databases supports this, you can use it. Okay, and there are some, well, if you are using MS Access or if you are using a very low cardinal or low supported RDBMSs, in that case you can use them. Okay, so this is just operator. If you know Oracle, this is a 1 minute job of learning. Union, union all, just selecting the operator. So here, one more point. Sometimes general in an interview discussion. I have first table 10 columns and I have second table only 2 columns. So how will you do? Say for example, in the same case, so now I have only employee number linking here from employee name linking here. So remaining all not there. So if you select operator component here and if you come to here, it will show you target columns. These are all target columns, and if you see yellow, there are coming from one input, okay, but they are not linked any. So this is coming from two, this is coming from two, but it is not coming from two, it is coming from one only. And now I am going to link it to the target. So why I have not linked, assume that in this table I don't have any other columns. Just for a moment, assume that I have only two columns in the first, second table. But if you see, since there is no link, okay, it is all giving as a yellow. And to clearly, if you want to see, you can go to attributes. So these are all your target columns going to the right side. And this is the first input. And this is the second input, and all these second inputs, okay, for remaining rest of columns, we don't have any input. So what we can do, either, so now if I run it, so this is a limitation, not only limitation, it is a mandatory, even in a databases also. Whenever you are trying to combine the data, in first table how many columns you are giving, and in the second table also you are supposed to give all. But here the question would be, if everything is there, I can drag it, fine. But the question is, now I don't have columns. The second table I have only employee number and employee name. So you can go and fill these columns with any default value. So most preferably you can fill it all with null. You can say null, 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 or you can keep 0, 0, 0, whatever you wish. Okay. So this is also a standard question. The concept is whenever you are using union or union all or any set operator, all the input metadata should match. Okay, how many number of columns you are selecting from all the inputs. Okay, in every input you should have same number of columns, and also data type should match. Okay, rather than explaining all these things, you can simply say, use word metadata. Metadata of all the input should match, means number of columns. Example, I'll show here. You can easily understand now. So now in the first table I have employee number, comma employee name from this table. And in the second table I don't have employee name column. So I'm just, I have only one column. And trying to say union. Or union all, anything you can, we will get the error. So all the metadata of every input should match number of columns and also data types. So in case if you do not have, so still I don't have the employee names, and first table I have employee name, but still second table I don't have, but I still want to combine. So you can say null. So this way you can, so the same rule is applicable in the ODA also. So here you can fill everything with your null or put zero or something, whatever is relevant for you. Okay, so that is the so now the last one is data set. So data set is not an important one, but I'll quickly show you how. So if anybody worked on ODI 11 or ODI older versions, any one of the older version, data set will give you the functionality of ODI 11. So generally I can place multiple sources, join, do lot of things here. Okay, but what the data set does, if you click it, immediately it will show you some components here. Means you can develop a logic, okay, and which contains joins, filters, lookups, and reusable. Reusable mappings right now we don't know. Okay, but what we can do, we can place lookups, we can place joins, we can, and that all it will show like one group. Data set means one result set. Okay, so what I am doing right now, when you have a placed data set, I can go and directly place all the sources into this data set. Okay, right now I am placing employee number, or sorry, employee table. EMP. So if you see, this time I am placing table on the data set, not on the mapping. And now, if I want to apply a filter in 11, ODI 11, you will not have any components like this. If you want to apply a filter in ODI 11, select a column on which you want to apply a filter. So now I want to apply filter on a salary column. So select that column and drag and release outside. Why it is going out? Okay, salary. Okay, this is how I'll drag outside. If at all it is a ODI 11. And for this component filter, now I can put a condition, salary greater than 0. And after salary, you want to, after filter, you want to put anything, nothing can be kept. Okay, it will be like a simple filter. Now I want to join this with employee department table. And how I will join two tables in ODI 11, I can link, okay, this table column directly and release onto this one. It will ask you, do you want to create a join or a lookup? I'll say join. You will see like this. And then here I need to give a condition. So, since I have dragged department number to department number, so a condition already created. Okay, so we have created, this is how you can create a lookup or a join or anything. So, finally, ultimately, if you click this data set, it will show you what are the tables you have placed in your data set. So, two tables. Data store means tables. How many joins? There is a join. If you have lookups, if you have converted or you have opted for a lookup, it will show that in the lookup list. And do you have any filters? One filter. So this entire, okay, what is this overall? This is nothing but select EMP, DEPT where EMP.departmentNumber equal to DEPT.departmentNumber and salary greater than 0 is one group. One SQL. All this logic we kept into one data set here. So generally why they added here is if you import any ODI 11G mapping, maybe in ODI 11 these mappings whatever you are developing are called as interfaces. In ODI 11G we will call these whatever we are developing here is called as interfaces. So, when you import ODI 11G interface to this particular 12C, that entire interface will be showing like this in, as a data set. So, you can make this as a data set and further, I can use this data set. Let's say, I can use expression and I can link from here to here. So, what are the outputs you will get from the data set? I can take here. And if you want to put any logics, in the 11G kind of mapping, you cannot place one after one. So, this is two tables. You are joining. Filter, that's all. There is a no concept of component, putting more than one component. So, now after filter, I want to do something. These are all not possible in older versions. Same thing. So, data set means you go back to ODI 11. What you are doing in ODI 11 is this. If you want to learn ODI 11, do it in ODI data set. So, that is what your ODI 11. Okay. But what you do in outside is all 12. So, you can place these components and you can place one after one. That is the reason ODI 12C is a flow based approach. Means flow means I can design a flow, first filter, then sort, then distinct like this. But in 11, it is maximum this. Then I can link this to a target. And even if you go to physical, you will see I did something wrong. The school data set. So we are taking all the columns, okay, employee, employee number, department, department number, name and everything, and this is the final target. Okay, so though it is a data set, okay, everything sitting. So when you can use it in still in 12C, say for example, your mapping is going to be very, very big. Okay, it is going to be very unmanageable. So you have so many components kept. For easy logical grouping of your code, okay, you can just place your code into one data set, one data set, one data set, and then you can further continue your logics. And if you see your physical diagram, it will still show you, it will not show any difference. So you are taking two tables, you have applied a filter, and then you are joining, and then you have expression, something like this. So ODI will show all put together, it will not show any differentiation here. So that's the reason, don't worry too much about the data set, okay, this is what your simple, everything will be combined to a single one. You're joining, putting, and that's all. You'll not feel any difference. So 12C people, you can simply ignore the data set. What we have showed you, that's all, if you know, that's all. So this is all our basic components, okay, so now we'll have actual ODA. So this is all basic SQL, joining, lookup, and then this. Okay. So to get into multiple things, okay, we can slowly get into the other parts. First, to show the so far, what is the knowledge module I am using right now? Only IKM. We didn't touch anything. Okay. So in the IKM also big list is there, but still I am using only one IKM, that is IKM SQL insert, that's all. So there is a big list of IKMs are there that will continue. So before that, for the first time, I'll bring you to the world where we require LKM. So to make you understand how LKM will be working and how LKM together IKM will be working, okay, all that we'll be discussing now. Then we'll go to the IKMs. So now our focus. So to bring it, we know whenever I need to load data to work tables, temporary work tables, okay, I need a LKM. So what I am doing for first time, I want to read data from a file and load data to somewhere else. Or I want to read data from a file, apply some conditions or join with other table. Anything. So first we'll see how to read data from a file, since it is something okay, so this will be require definitely some LKMs, and that's how we'll see LKM usage, and then IKM will continue. Okay, so when you take data, okay, so basically so far all the information is available in a table. But in case you want, we can also store data in a file. Mostly high level, you can classify your files into multiple ways. Okay, one, you can classify files as a structured. We'll see what is structured. Okay, semi-structured. And unstructured. So sometimes, okay, the mainframe file comes under semi-structured only, okay, but very high level, you can say structured, unstructured, and semi-structured, And first I am going about, okay, examples. Okay, semi-structured is XML, okay, and then mainframe, files, okay, lot of things. So unstructured, okay, your PDF, okay, and any documents. Structured, okay. So mostly this is, we are not going to talk now, and this is also we are not going to talk now. Okay, so our focus is on structured. What is structured means? I will place data in a file in a very structured format. Semi-structured, unstructured, okay, mostly unstructured will be dealt in big data. Okay, we can write MapReduce programs and all that. And of course, like even the ODI supports, Informatica supports processing unstructured data as well, but that all out of scope, just ignore it. So we'll be focusing or discussing only structured data here. Structured means information keeping in a file in a structured format. So when you are planning to keep data in a file, okay, you can place the data in a file in two types. One is in a fixed width, and delimited. Okay, first I'll take example. I have some department data. This is in a table, but I'm planning to store it in a file. You can create any file. Basically a notepad or anything. Okay, one plain file. And I'm planning to keep here. So I'm showing you how you can keep in a fixed width. So now I am planning to store department number, department name and location. If I am planning to keep this data in this table, sorry, in this file, and then if I want to make allow others to understand what is that information we have here. So if I just keep data like this, nobody can understand. So now I have a department number. If I call, maybe at least we can understand. If I call third person, tell him, give this file. Okay, you cannot understand this data. What is 10? What is accounting? Okay, accounting new is there. Whether it's accounting new is one word or accounting is another word and new arg is another word, nobody can understand. That's why to make others understand. Okay, so now I'm planning to keep this data in a fixed width format. Fixed width means for every column, I will allocate fixed length. Okay, so first, how many number of characters maximum you may keep for a department number? So that you have to decide. So 2 right now. If it is 3 also fine, but decide what is the maximum length for your department number. So I'm planning 2. Okay, so always I'll keep in first 2 columns department number. Okay, 1 and second position is department number. Means department number starting position is 1 and how many length? 2. So the next column I will give this information to others. Okay, when you are reading, first 1 and 2 characters is a department number. In the entire file, first 2 characters you will read it as a department number. You will understand. So then I am saying department name. It will start from 3. Where your department name will end in every record, every line. Okay, that I am. So now you decide what is the maximum length, okay, you allocate for department name. So we see what is the maximum accounting ending here? 10. So wherever, since my maximum department name will have 10, it is a 15, 20, you decide. So always I will end, okay, from here to here. But if you see, research is having only fewer characters, okay, but I decided to allocate 10 spaces for department name. So I will start my third column from the 11th only. Sales, it is already, but five characters only, but I have given 10. Operations, 10. Okay, so from 3 to 10 characters, it is a department name. So he will read. So from here to here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 plus 2, 12. So total 13, okay, we have completed now. 13. See, this is 10 and 2. 12, right? And then last column, anything, 1 or 2 here and there, forget. Okay, so now, where it will start, where I am starting the last one, see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, and from 13th position till end, you don't need to give, because how to represent end in a character in a file? Entire character, okay, your ASCII character or line terminator. So you don't need to give any line. So this way I can prepare a file and then keep the data. I'll give this information. So first two characters is department number. Second, starting from 3 up to 10 characters, length 10, length, whatever I given 10. Anyway, whatever way you like to represent, you give it that information so that somebody can understand. So these kind of files are called fixed width files. So that in entire, you have, let's say, 1 million lines. In every line, first two characters, department name, then third character to up to 10 length, up to 12th character, it is a department name, then all will be department location. This is the fixed width. So then, the most important is delimited only. So now it is a bit too much technical. When you keep the data in a fixed weight, it is too much technical. Only technical programs can understand. So because you have to read, human being cannot easily understand, because I need to always calculate length and all that. But it is one of the best way, but for a human being point of view, it is not that very comfortable. So that's why we have an alternate option called delimited. So rather than you giving the length and fixing up the length, delimit. So to give a boundary, where is your column ending in every line, okay, we will break up every column with one character. We will delimit, we'll break or we'll keep some curtain from one column to other column. Okay, and that is called delimited. How do you delimit? You can use any one of the keyboard character to delimit. I can use a comma, pipe, semicolon, tab, anything which is available in the keyboard. But what are the very good characters you can use for delimit? Tab, okay, semicolon, comma, okay, pipe. These are the very commonly used characters to delimit. So first I will try to delimit, okay, this with a pipe. So I am just taking data again. So this time what I am doing, to break up every line, to break up every column, okay, I am trying to you see, here I am in end of the every column, I am keeping a character called pipe. So this is a delimited file, but the character which I am using to delimit these columns are pipe. So I will call this file as a pipe delimited file. Okay, so you can just create it and then save it. So now I am going to save it. So this is DEPT, I'll say pipe. You can give any name, and then I'm saving it as a text file. Just close it. So if I give this file to anyone, I'll say that this is a pipe delimited file. So you'll go and read it. Wherever pipe is there, first column, second column, third column, like this. Now, again, this is a very best way of representation, but again, it is not very convenient for human beings. So same file, what I am doing, I am copy pasting. This time I am, rather than using pipe, I am using comma here this time. So both are same, but this is a pipe delimited, but this is a comma delimited. Both are same. But what is the advantage of the comma? If at all, if you use comma, there is one good advantage. If at all, if I have created a comma delimited file, if I separate every column with comma, and if I save this as a, so this previously I have saved as a text file, but this time I am saving this as a file with a name .csv. So I am giving this file name as .csv. CSV stands for comma separated valued file. Okay, so whenever you save your comma separated file with .csv extension, this file will be recognized by Microsoft. This is .csv. Both are same, but this extension is .csv and this is a .txt. Advantage is I can open it in Excel directly. Okay, if you right click and say edit, you will see like data is in a notepad only, but at the same time this also can be opened in a Excel. So mostly people, how to read Excel? Mostly we don't really recommend to use Excel files. We'll recommend to use these kind of files. Mostly people will also call them as Excel, but it is not a real Excel. Excel means a file when you save extension with .xls. So those XLS files cannot be read easily like this. That we have to deal separately. What is this? It is Excel only with .csv, comma separated valued file, and this we can easily read it. Okay, so now at least we know what is comma delimited and fixed with, and within that mostly you will deal with .csv files or Excel files, okay, which are separated by comma. Okay, now I'll show one small problem, and then so now I have data like this. I can open in Excel. So now what I have here, I have one department, okay, 99. Okay, name is Apple. So address is, okay, by keep APRTS, okay. So now have a department number, department name, and this is the address, location. Okay, now, what is this? This is a one column actually, but I am typing my full address in that column. So, now I will open it. So, what is this file? We told that this is a delimited file, comma separated value file. Inner meaning is, wherever comma is there, make a separate it. That is the reason, what it does is right, but actually for me it is wrong. Why? These three are supposed to be in single column, but since you have given comma, that is coming as your data, your address having some comma. But this file also is a comma separated, okay, you will have that problem. So that is the reason what I can do, whenever you have this kind of, these are all whatever I am describing will be challenges or behaviors of your data, you will be somehow one or another part will encounter. So in this situation, what you can do, you can, whenever you want to cancel the behavior of the delimited character, okay, you surround those columns or you surround complete that column with a single or a double quote, which is called text qualifier. So you can keep entire, or you can keep the single quote, double quote for all the columns or for a single column. Okay, so it is going to, all the technologies, the concept is same. It's not only ODI, Informatica, DataStage, ODI, BODS or anywhere. Okay, so since I want to consider or I want to cancel the comma behavior to not to act like a separator. So whenever you surround values within single or double quotes, it will lose the behavior of the delimited. So now if I open this, you will be seeing them. So everything what we are discussing will be having option in ODI. Okay. So this is a very basic, and tomorrow we'll talk about the heading and all that, we'll see tomorrow.